So let's talk about digital education and digital entrepreneurship and digital economy, which are on the rise across frontier Africa, resulting in notable investments from within and outside the continent. And you had an interview earlier with Abby, the CEO for AVCA. Now, despite this progress, we're still scratching the surface in terms of the benefits and the potentials we can harness on the continent by using digital technology as a game changer. Joining me for a discussion on this is a digital professional, an author, consultant, and founder of the Digital CEO Africa Summit Initiative. Samson Olatunde joins me from our Lagos studios. It's good to see you here, my friend.
Thank you. Thank you for having me here.
Great. It's a public holiday in Nigeria, so we appreciate your making it here this evening, dinner time. Give me a brief about your Digital CEO Africa Summit Initiative and what you're looking to achieve in the near to long term.
Thank you. Digital CEO African Summit is powered by Digital CEO Tribe. It's a community of digital survey professionals. And then we have a mandate to empower 1 million Africans across the African countries. We've been successful to go to some part of the country. We've gone to South Africa, we've gone to Nigeria, which is my own country. We've had the addition of the Digital CEO African Summit. We've gone to Ghana. And the whole idea is to get career professionals and entrepreneurs together to understand the rudiments around how they can deploy technology to achieve more, build locally, and then go globally to sell and to reach out to more people. Year by year, we try to make this happen, and at least we have 3 years. By 2023, we believe that we should have empowered 1 million Africans across these countries.
Interesting. Now with the pandemic, you dealing with this Digital Africa CEO Summit. These are very good images of the previous years, but here we are in 2021. Is it still holding on your closing shop?
So what we did was to hold the virtual edition, and then we did last 2 months, we did the edition for Dubai, and then we had Nigerians in Dubai come together in a webinar to have access to information on how they can deploy and take advantage of opportunities on the internet. Aside that, every week on our platform, Digital CEO Tribe, we host different experts where they share knowledge from how you can deploy technology to educational sector, to telecoms, whatever sector you may be in. As of today, we've done 36 episodes during the course of the pandemic in the space of 1 year. We realize that technology doesn't stop us from doing what we need to do. It doesn't matter where you are. As far as you have access to the internet, and then you have a way of logging in, you have access to information. So our joy is that we have a platform that can connect people all over the world, especially Africans across board. And then we just continue doing what we are doing, but most importantly, deploy technology to keep teaching people what they need to do and get them empowered.
So talking about teaching people, what trends are you seeing across sub-Saharan Africa in terms of digital learning? What education and skills can this and digital space avail the youths and get them and create jobs?
I think it's getting interesting from the feedback we are getting, and based on the thought we've heard so far and all of the trainings we've done on different webinars across board. I think people are beginning to realize that there's a need for them to know more about how things are done on the internet. So you have more people getting interested in understanding what they can do in terms of cyber security. So you have people learning robotics, you have people learning Internet of Things, you have people understanding how they can deploy technology in different perspectives. So for instance, if you look at different sectors, from telecoms, there's a lot of problems that need the deployment of technology. You go to education, you have that. And our own job as an organization and as a pioneer of Digital CEO African Summit is to see how we can make this knowledge available to people or platforms where they can connect to take advantage of all of this opportunity. There's a lot of problems, no doubt about it. Government can't do everything, but we believe that with skills that people can acquire, and then they can have access to a lot of platforms to deploy it, we will reduce the rate of unemployment, and we have a lot of people having the right skill sets for them to be employed in different organizations across different sectors.
But are you seeing enough enabling environments or policies or actions by governments or sovereigns around Africa, policymakers and others, in supporting the continent's digital revolution? Do you think the governments are moving at the fast pace, the pace that is fast and quick enough to support what some of you are doing, Samson?
Unfortunately, in this part of the world, in my country, Nigeria, or even in different part of African countries, governments are not doing enough in terms of infrastructure, in terms of the physical and digital infrastructure. We are far, far behind. In terms of the curriculum, I mean, look at our university, look at the tertiary institution, look at the primary and the secondary schools. You see that we are still using the old curriculum. I mean, so many things are happening across the world, but in this part of the world, we are still far, far behind. And then you see that even investors are coming outside the country to come invest in our talent. That means we've got a lot of talent, for instance, in Nigeria. And I know that definitely across board in different African countries, based on our interaction with people, many people have ideas. They're looking for funding. They're looking for people to make it happen. But in our country, in different African countries, government are supposed to be the one to make all of this funding available to people. We have BOI, we have different sectors that can make this funding available, but it's getting more difficult for young talent across African countries to have access to this. And so, aside the infrastructure that we have issues with, I think there's a lack of know-how. Many people don't know what to do when they get on platform. Many people don't know how to activate different opportunities on different platforms. We have a lot of people using mobile device, but don't even know how to take advantage of opportunities on the internet. That's because in all of the sectors that we have, when we talk about from our educational sector to telecoms, to when you're going for internship to NYSC, for instance, in Nigeria, there's a need for us to incorporate this in our curriculum and begin to make people learn the rudiments on how they can use digital to achieve so many things for themselves. And I think that if we can do that, which government is supposed to make that happen, it will fasten the ability of many people activating the digital to do so many things for themselves. So primarily for me, I think there's a lack of the digital infrastructure, there's a lack of the know-how, and if those two things can be fixed across board, we'll have a lot of people activating the digital platform to do a lot of things for themselves.
If you put your shopping list together and you're handing it over to the Nigerian authorities, for example, speaking specifically to Nigeria, what are the top three that issues that you'd want to be fixed very quickly for you in your industry?
For me, I think there's a need, number one, for a revamping in our curriculum across board. Revamping our curriculum in the educational sector, revamping when it comes to our lecturers, our teachers, teaching the pupils, teaching in our institution, teaching across board. There's a need for a proper curriculum that will put in place most of the things many of the teachers need to learn, or the lecturers across board, for those who are coming in to learn as students. There's a need for us to repackage our curriculum because we are far behind in terms of what is happening across board all over the world. Number two, I think there's a need for us to begin to think about digitalization. We are still doing many things manually. There's a need for us to look at it across board in all sectors, from the telecoms to the educational sector to the marketplace to all of those sectors. There's a need for us to see how we can incorporate technology. So for instance, I mean, you can hardly see any university in Nigeria that have access to wireless connection. And once you step into that environment, you have access to connect and use the infrastructure of that university. We hardly have that currently in Nigeria. And just imagine us having that activated in all the universities, all the primary school, all the secondary school. That would be massive to make people learn more at a go. Informal learning aside, you coming to your school, coming to the classroom to learn. You can learn informally because you have access wherever you are in a school environment, for instance, to have access to technology and you can do a lot of things for yourself. So I believe strongly that if that aspect of curriculum revamping can be done, number two, we can put more money investment into the aspect of digital and our physical infrastructure. And the last thing is that we should look at the investment. How can all of these startups come in and invest into all of these talents?
We've got to go at this point. Thank you so much for your time today. Samson Olatunde, digital entrepreneur, author, and founder of the Digital Africa Initiative. Thank you so much. See you next time.